Wendo say, come testify. Oh, Wendo say, come testify. Lord, I want to be in the night. My whole testimony shall be there. Oh, Wendo say, shall receive my holy. Somebody taking your holy, your whole bride. Oh, when the saint, hallelujah. Oh, when the saint, go get the prize. Oh, when the saint, get the prize. Lord, I want to be here. I must be there. You will be there. We will hold me there. I will see you there, you will see me there. Lord, I want to be. We will hold me there. When the saint, somebody marching in. Oh, when the saint, marching onto the place. Oh, when the saint, we will hold me there, we'll see ourselves. Hallelujah. We will sing on the song of victory. Doing a blood for Jesus. Go break. Lord, I want to be. Lord, to be the number. Oh, when the saint. Somebody in his side. Come on. Oh, when the saint. Come testify. Oh, when the saint. Come testify. Lord, I want to be. Oh, when the saint, oh, when the saint, yeah, hey, hey, oh, when the saint, go get the price. Oh, when the saint, go get the price. Lord, I want to be, I shall be there. You will be there. Oh, when the saint, oh, 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 when the saint, come testify.
Lift up your two hands to heaven and thank God for the privilege to be a part of this awesome movement. This proof producing revival. This testimony generating awakening. Give God thanks for the privilege to be a partaker of this awesome time in God's presence. Lift up those two hands and give God thanks. In Jesus' precious name, we have given thanks. Now ask the Lord to speak to you tonight. Come on, go ahead and do it. Speak to me tonight. The Lord sent one word into Jacob. He turned every aspect of his life around. Let my word come tonight. The few minutes we have. Let my word come tonight. Let my own word come tonight. Let my turnaround word come tonight. Let my spirit energizing word come tonight. Let my life quickening word come tonight. Thank you, Father. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. Father, thank you for answers to all of our prayers. And thank you for what this last week of this operation represents. Lord, I pray that no one here shall be left behind. I pray for release of grace to match the demands of this last week. Let it be, Lord, in Jesus' name. Give the Lord a big hand of praise. And please, you may be seated. From scriptures, we understand faith is the substance of things expected. It means whatever is not expected, faith cannot deliver. Faith is the expectation that gives credence to faith. It is expectation that validates faith. So, the prayer of faith is all about praying answer expectant prayer, which is the only way to receive anything from God. James 1, 6 and 7. But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he that wavereth is like a wave of the sea, driven and tossed with the wind, driven and tossed. For let not that man think he shall receive anything from the Lord. So expectation must remain intact to qualify for interventions and manifestations. Let not that man think he shall receive anything from God. Let him ask in faith with established expectation without wavering. Otherwise, let him not think he shall receive anything from God. Now, we have a very clean illustration here on praying answer expectant prayers as Christ demonstrated in the feeding of 5,000. He already asked them to sit down in 50s to feed 5,000 men with only 2 loaves, only 5 loaves and 2 fishes. He made them to sit down for a meal that was yet to arrive. Absolutely expectant and confident of answers to his prayers. Give ye them to eat, and that he said to prove them, for himself knew what he would do. John chapter 6 and verse 6. Philip said, look, 200 pence of bread is not enough for this one. We are in the desert. How do we get it? This he said to prove them, for himself knew what he would do. And he took the 5 loaves and 2 fishes and gave thanks. They were already seated. Nobody was struggling. They got this food delivered in baskets from the throne of God. It's a clear demonstration of answer expectant prayers. And this we need to embrace the remaining days of this month, of this operation. Evidently, not all men that pray expect answers to their prayers. They pray to satisfy their religious soul, so they can tell anybody, I've prayed 3 hours on this matter. I've prayed 10 years on this subject. Nothing has happened. Because the substance that will make things happen, or something to happen, is not there. So for the evenings that we have, we'll be looking at praying answer expectant prayers. And I believe that this bit of exhortation would change your prayer life forever. Prayer without expectation is wasted communication. Nothing will come out of it. Any prayer that is void of faith can never deliver. Whatever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them and ye shall have them. Mark 11:24. So prayer is a non-negotiable requirement for prayer. Faith is a non-negotiable requirement for prayer to be answered. And that's so important. And what is faith? The substance of things expected. The evidence of things not seen. By this mystery, all the elders obtain a good report. That is the gateway to good reports in a believer's journey. Engaging the force of faith to assess what belongs to us from the prayer altar. Praying answer expectant prayers. We saw the story of Abraham's servant, how he engaged this mystery in his search for a wife for Isaac in Genesis 24, verse 12 to 21. O Lord God of my master Abraham, I pray thee, send me good speed this day and show kindness to my master Abraham. Behold, I stand here by the well of water. The daughters of the men of the city come out to draw water. He said, and let it come to pass that the damsel to whom I shall say, let down thy pitcher, I pray thee, that I may drink. And she shall say, drink, and I will give thy camels drink also. Let the same be she that thou hast appointed for my servant Isaac, for thy servant Isaac. And thereby shall I know that thou hast showed kindness unto my master. You know the remainder of the story. The daughters of the men of the city came to the well to fetch water. Can I have a drink? Oh yes, I'll give you. And I give it to your camels also. Divine speed. By praying, answer expectant prayers. Let every prayer you pray from this time forward, therefore, be pregnant with expectation. This is the prayer subject, and here is my expectation for answers. Let your expectation be as intact and intense as your prayers. Don't let any negative thought cross your mind against what you are praying. Don't pray with, I've done my best, whether it's now answered or not, it's left for God. No, no, it's left for you. God has no part in that. It's a covenant-keeping God. When you are where you should be, you have committed God's integrity to perform. All we need is to be pregnant with expectation, with all our supplications and intercessions at all times. That was how gloriously God found a wife for Isaac. Divine speed is facilitated by praying answer expectant prayers. Answer expectant prayers. Answer expectant prayers. Answer expectant prayers. That is, you pray it and you are expectant of its practical delivery. Not delivery in spiritual realm. Practical delivery. This coming Sunday, Canaan land shall be turned into a city without walls. And your spirit man can envision and see the flock of people coming in, and you can't stop saying it. You are just saying it and enjoying saying it. No one ever arrives at a future that he cannot see. As far as your eyes can see, unto you will I give it. You can't see it, I can't give it. Genesis chapter 13, verses 14 and 15. For all the land which thou seest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed forever. Until you can see it, I can't give it. You must see it for me to give it. So begin to see the reality. We must keep seeing the reality of what you have prayed for. We must keep seeing the reality of what you have prayed for. We must keep seeing the reality of what you have prayed for. I've said often here on this platform that I'm not surprised that we're where we are. Thank God for making it happen. Well, I would have been surprised if we are not there. Why? The reality of the future was more real than the present. Because on the basis of the truth, he never lies. Okay, why won't God answer us? For instance, he wants all men to be saved and come to the knowledge of the truth. So it is his will to have all men saved. And we're saying, God, let all the unsaved across our harvest field hear your compelling sound and be drafted here for their salvation. He said, that's my will. Their deliverance, that's what I died for. And for the establishment in the faith, that's my will. So why won't God answer us? If we will pray, answer expectant prayers, we never lack testimonies. You pray, answer expectant prayers, you never run out of testimonies. So we must keep seeing the reality of what we have prayed for without wavering. This is it. That's where we're going. I was told our son had jaundice, and I said, he cannot have it. Doctor said, look at it. I said, it's not necessary. Because I can't expect him to have it. I never expect him to have it. He disappeared on his own without anybody looking at the eyes. Went back to where it came from. Let's be addicted to praying, answer expectant prayers. You pray it, you can see it, you have committed God to give it. Now watch it. What will happen in this fifth phase will baffle everybody beyond all that has ever happened in this church. Amen. If we will engage this truth among others. You engage this truth among others. Somebody's breaking forth. Amen. You are that one, let me hear your loudest amen. Amen. In Romans chapter 4, we saw the expectation of intact, of Abraham, very intact. Chapter 4, verse 17. Talking about Abraham, he said, as it is written, I've made thee a father of many nations, before whom he believed, even God, who quickeneth the dead and called those things that be not as though they were. He said, who against hope believed in hope that he might become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall thy seed be. And being not weak in faith, his expectation remained intact. He considered not his own body now dead, neither yet the deadness, when he was about 100 years old, and neither yet the deadness of Sarah's womb. He staggered not at the promise of God's own belief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God. And verse 21, and being fully persuaded that what God had promised, he was able also to perform. Expectation brought Isaac to being. Where expectation ends, that's where your victory ends. Where expectation stops, that's where answer to your prayer stops. For instance, the word says, ask of me, and I'll give you the heathen for an inheritance. How do you ask? But let him ask in faith, nothing wavering. For he will dance like a wave of the sea, and let not that man think he shall receive anything from God. ask and I will give you the heathen for an inheritance and the uttermost part of the earth for thy possession. So it's a covenant. It's a deal. If you will ask expectantly, you have committed me to respond. You have committed my integrity to respond. Okay, before she traveled, she brought forth. Before her pain came, she was delivered of a man child who has had such a thing. Shall the earth be made to bring forth in one day? Or shall a nation be born at once? For as soon as Zion traveled, making traveling demands for the earth to bring forth in one day and for a nation to be born at once, she brought forth her children. Traveling expectantly. This is what you said to do, and I am doing it. Therefore, in the name of Jesus the Christ, let the earth bring forth at once this Sunday. And let a nation be born at once this coming Sunday. Do it, O God. He said, yes, you have traveled in faith. You have committed me. I will cause the earth to bring forth at once. Can I hear your loudest amen? Amen. All that is missing in most of our prayer life is established expectation, unshakable expectation. That's what is lacking. We pray it, we are not sure. We pray it again, we are not sure. We doubt as much as we pray. So when will the prayer be answered? But these remaining days, you will see raw answers to prayers that will change your prayer life forever. You will see raw answers to prayers that will change your prayer life forever. You are going to see raw answers to prayers. Amen. So I want to take your position. Just take your own individual positions against this coming Sunday. Praying what you must see on Sunday. Praying what you must see on Sunday. Praying what you must see on Sunday. Don't bother yourself about God. He has unlimited capacity to deliver anything. There is nothing too hard for him. When he stretches forth his hand, no one can turn it back. God is not, we never need sympathy. He has more than enough for any one of us and much more for his work. And much more for his work. So this is not praying that the prayer that will be answered someday, the prayer that must be delivered this Sunday. That's the last day of this operation. What we have never seen in the history of this church, we're going to see it on Sunday. Amen. Through the fiery power of faith. So receive grace to be an Elijah for the hour. Whose voice will be registered in heaven and whose demand will be delivered on the earth. Can I hear your amen? That's the way to do it. My voice must be registered in heaven this week. And my demands must be delivered on the earth on Sunday. This week, I'm praying the prayer that must be delivered. And that's what you have. None of your converts will be left behind. Amen. They will not only come, they will come with their friends. Amen. What do? You begin to pray. You send them texts. You call them. Come with your friend. We have this special miracle service this coming Sunday. We don't know when we're going to have the next one. Market Jesus in truth. Look at that. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. I will never lie. The miracles you have never seen before you see on Sunday. Amen. God never leads backward. He always leads forward. God never leads backward. He always leads forward. This Sunday we'll see what you have never seen. As cripples begin to walk out of their wheelchairs. As the blind begin to receive their brand new sight. As God begins to do the unusual among his people. That is what we should set ourselves for. And that's what we are going to see. As we pray it, with this mystery of answer expectant prayer, Watch the difference this coming Sunday. And watch the difference in your prayer life. Can I hear your loudest amen? Amen. One of our precious people that came in from India, I was told, bought a large number of winning prayers. He said that book did a lot for her and would be very helpful to all my new converts. We bought a last talk to be given to our new converts. There are people here who have not taken responsibility to broaden their insight in the things. They're just, we need to be educated. We need to be enlightened. We need to be informed. We need to be informed on anything that will deliver outstanding results. It's over to us. I believe this week will be 1 week you'll be talking about for a long time. Because from your prayer altar, you will encounter God. I see him tapping you and say, stand up and follow me. I see him tapping you and asking you, sit down, take your note, and get this done. You are going to see God. If you add the morning exhortation to this one, engage your heart. And then pray, answer, expectant prayer. Pray it from your heart. Pray it from your heart. Don't just get involved intellectually. Don't just get involved with your soul. Get involved with your spirit. And see how God reaches down to you. You must have not just answers to your prayers. You must have encounters with God. Stand to your feet, everybody. Whatever grace you think you need to make the most of this hour in praying, answer, expectant prayer. Reach out to heaven with your two hands up and begin to call for it. Lord, I desire a new order of grace of my life. A new order of grace on my prayer altar. Father, endue me with a new level of faith in praying, answer, expectant prayers. I look forward to your direct, raw manifestation this Sunday. As multitudes are drafted into this church, and as multitudes turn their life over to Christ, and as multitudes get instantly established in the faith, descend in your might this coming Sunday. With signs, wonders, special miracles and mighty deeds among us. Let there be an explosion of the apostolic unction this coming Sunday. Bringing about the unusual among your people. Massive turnaround testimonies. I receive grace to make specific demands that I must see this coming Sunday. Lord, engrace me to be an Elijah of this moment, whose voice must be heard in heaven and whose demands must be delivered on the earth. Lord, grace to be listed as an Elijah this week. I receive it from you. One whose voice must be heard in heaven and whose demands must be delivered on the earth. I receive that grace tonight. Come and lift up your two hands. Pray in the Holy Ghost right now. Pray in the Holy Ghost right now. This is your chance to have your voice registered in heaven and your demands delivered raw on the earth. Oh Lord God, do the unusual. Let there be minimum twice last Sunday's attendance this coming Sunday. You have all it takes to do it. Unto men it's impossible, not with God, for with God all things are possible. Rabaka roda suale praktana rada. Zezirada prokteno radia le suze. Pray that prayer from the depth of your heart. Something is breaking forth. Something is breaking forth. Something is breaking forth. Something is breaking forth. Arado berakaru ale swa. The kind of miracles you have never seen before. Let it be. 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 Take that grace from heaven. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. I will restore health unto thee. Now listen to me. No sickness will escape next Sunday. You are resting finally from all sickness and diseases. I said, this coming Sunday, every winner and their invitees and their new combat, you are resting finally from every assault of sickness and disease. As the Lord liveth, no sickness or disease will remain in anyone's body. So get ready and come and take it for free. Come and this thing is real. This thing is real. Many are in it. You are the only one remaining. You must jump on this chariot. You must jump on this chariot. Your health must become a testimony among men. You will not know sickness again in your family. Hospital will no longer become your reference. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we'll be going from strength to strength from this time forward. And what more, this coming Sunday, God will turn you to a sign and a wonder. You are not looking for miracles anymore. You'll become a distributor of miracles. You 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 become a distributor of miracles. So shall it be. Everyone you say come to for this Sunday service will follow you. Anyone, no matter how unwilling he may look, you are going with me to church this Sunday. He may say, "Ben, we're song," but he will come. He will come. He will call you back and say, "Look, I'm sorry for the way I responded. I will go with you." He said, "Do I come to stay in your house?" Or, "Oh, no, no, I'll come and pick you. You can also come with your friend." "Yeah, I have two friends who will come with me." This, anybody, you see, it's one thing to pray. I'm not going to believe that your prayer is answered. Anybody you say, come to, that you open your mouth to say, come to, that you call on the phone, you say, come. Everybody say, come, we fall. We follow. They will all follow you. They will all follow you. I said, get ready. Let's see you. Get ready. Security, get ready. We are going to be invaded. We shall be invaded. We have never run a one-month prayer before. This is the first time. So whatever we have never seen before, we'll see it this time. So pray this answer expectant prayers with all zeal and zest. Don't run through those 60 lines at the same time. You don't need that. Just pick one. Pray it through. Pick the next. Pray it through. Let the picture of the reality of your answers be before you. And keep it there unshakably. And you're going to see it raw with your eyes open. Lift up your two hands. As your voice is registered in heaven, your reward answers on the earth. As you pray for souls to be established, nothing shall shake your feet all through life. As you commit to advancing the kingdom of God, God will remain committed to your advancement. In the name of Jesus, this week in particular will lead to the dropping of at least one quantum leap of order of testimony in your life. As you reach out in faith, everyone you call will answer. Everyone you invite will arrive here. They not only arrive here, they will stay here. As you engage the prayer altar, every of your demands will be delivered for a testimony. This coming Sunday will be an open day for you. All the forces of heaven will deliver your demands. And the name of the Lord shall be glorified. Now receive strength. Because they go from strength to strength, every one of them that appears before God. Prayer is one platform where we appear before the Lord in Zion. Therefore, from now, begin to go from strength to strength. Begin to go from strength to strength. In the name of Jesus. We had one 82-year-old young lady last Sunday that was displayed in the front. Jumping, 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 jumping. And then fell on the floor and rolling and jump and jump. Now, that was somebody who came in with crutches. Jesus, I said, ask me, ask this woman what is her age. He said, 82. 82. 82 and was jumping and jumping. Every weakness remaining in anyone's body, Some are not sick, they are just weak. They are just weak. They are just weak. There is weakness in every fiber of their body. Every weakness is cursed in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. Wave those hands to heaven and celebrate Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' precious name. We have flyers for next Sunday's special miracle service. You can pick them up. They are already blessed. The breath of the Lord is upon them. Remember that this evening prayer service continues tomorrow. And then we have the covenant hour of prayer in the morning. And then our personal time is spent in inviting people, in reaching out to people in law for Christ. Glory to God. Lift up those two hands. Give God thanks one more time. Blessed be the name of the Lord. In the name of Jesus. Be blessed. This investment shall not be in vain. Everything you ever need is in what you are doing right now. And so shall it be. I declare you and release you a living testimony. Everybody is celebrating the mission of Matthew 6:33. You are the next in line. For your children, you are the next in line. For your grandchildren, you are the next in line. For your career, you are the next in line. For your business, you are the next in line. Matthew 6:33 will become your new song. He said, serving God overpays. People are sharing all kinds of testimony. Matthew 6:33 works like fire. In the name of Jesus, it will deliver your life. Lift up those two hands together. Let's share the goodness of the Lord in fellowship. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the presence of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Remember, your enough is enough order of testimony is on. And this week we are having it. Please send in your testimonies online. We will celebrate God for you. Glory to God. And there is no way you will run dry of testimony this season. This week in particular, some strange testimony was learned for you. In Jesus' name. From glory to glory. And from glory to glory. We're all getting there. Please congratulate your neighbors for me. At least three of them. Amen. And see you in the morning in Jesus' name.